utterly dependent on Jesus. And there's no point without him. It's a waste of time without him, right? Yeah. Feel free to sing with us. The song is simple, it says.
Tell me, what can I do? Cause I can't live without you. I can't live without you. Oh, tell me, what can I do? Cause I can't live without you. I can't live without you. Oh, tell me, what can I do? Cause I can't live without you. Can't live without you. Oh, tell me, what can I do? Cause I can't live without you. No, I can't live without you. So here's my heart. Here's my mind. I give you my soul, Lord. I need you to take control. Cause I tried it all. Tried it on my own. But what I found is I can't make it on my own. On my own. I can't make it. I can't make it. On my own. On my own. I can't make it. I can't make it. Yeah. So tell
Good evening, my name is Leah Marie and welcome to our television broadcast Sinning Points. We are from Pillars of Truth Ministries, a church in the heart of the community with a heart for the community. Join us every second and fourth Saturday of the month at 2:30 p.m. for our program. So sit back, call a friend or neighbor and be ministered to by our apostle.
And turn your Bibles to the book of Psalms 90, Psalms chapter 90. Reading from verses 10 to 12. It's a very familiar portion of scripture that we want to look at today. The days of our years are what? 70 at 70 years. And if by reason of strength they be 80 years, if we live till 80, yet is their strength labor and sorrow, for it is soon cut off. And we fly away. Moses is asking the question, who knoweth the power of thine anger? And even according to thy fear, so is thy wrath. And verse 12 says, teach us. So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. We're talking very briefly this morning on understanding my assignment. Understanding my assignment in this life. One of the most troubling questions that we all ask from time to time is, what am I here for? This has been a question that has been plaguing the minds of so many people. What am I here for? Why am I alive? What reason there is for me to be living? But from the time we were born until the time you die, God has a plan mapped out for your life. It was God speaking to Jeremiah 29 verse 11 when God says to him, I know the plans I have towards thee. And in typology, not only was he speaking to Jeremiah, but he's also speaking to us as the body of Christ. For I know the thoughts I think towards you, said the Lord, thoughts of peace, not of evil, to give you an expected end. Sometimes in life, brothers and sisters, we get a bad start. But let me tell you this morning, it's not how you start, but really how you finish that is important where your life is concerned. When you become born again, you are a foreigner and a stranger in this world. Hallelujah. And therefore, understanding your assignment is important. David in Psalms 119 verse 19 says, I am a stranger in this earth. Hide not thy commandment from me. All of you who were born again here this morning, let me say it again. You are strangers in this earth. We are pilgrims in this earth. And therefore, you have to understand this morning that you are on an assignment. And when your assignment is over, God will call you home. And you would stand to give an account for your life. One of the reasons why many of us are frustrated is simply because we are on our own agenda. And we don't understand our assignment in this life. Moses is crying out before the Lord. And he's saying this. He's saying, Lord, a man's lifespan is 70. You've given us 70 years on the face of the earth. And then he says, if by reason of strength, I would live to 80 years. But verse 12 says, Lord, you know what? Teach me. Teach me how to live those 80 years. So I may apply my heart unto wisdom. Let me tell you this morning, hallelujah, our identity is in eternity, and our home is in heaven. This world is not our home. This country is not your country, spiritually speaking. Even though we are in it, we are not of it. And let me tell you something this morning. You have to understand your assignment before you die. Because you are going to stand before God to give an account of your assignment on this earth. If I am bold enough to say this, you will never be truly happy in this life until you find yourself in the perfect will and plan of God for your life. And that is why Paul, writing to the Philippian church in Philippians 1:21, the Apostle Paul says, for me to live is Christ. The Apostle Paul understood his assignment. And he was saying that the things of the world do not control me. Because for me, to live is Christ and to die is gain. That's a man who understood assignment. Many of you sitting here this morning, you are delaying your own progress and destiny of others because you are disobedient to the will of God. When we don't do what God has ordained, those who are connected to us are also affected. Let me tell you this morning, and this might shock you. We are not just here to build homes. and to buy cars and to get married and to have children. We're not here just for that. There is a specific assignment that God has given to you. Whether you came through wedlock or out of wedlock, God has a plan for your life. None of us are insignificant. You are not a mistake. Let me say it again. You are not a mistake. God does not create mistakes. So whenever you came through the channels of marriage, or you were here before marriage, you hear me, God has a plan for your life. It is our responsibility now to find out what is our assignment before you die. The assignment of God upon our lives must be understood, must not be taken for granted. You see, when you understand your assignment, you don't waste time. You don't play the fool, because you realize that time is running out. Time is short. And whatever you have to do, you must do it quickly, because your assignment could end today. And one of the greatest questions we have to answer before God is, what did you do in the given assignment of your life? While we are busy trying to do this, and nothing is wrong with that, but I'm saying that your first priority in life as a child of God is to fulfill God's assignment over your life. Matthew 6:33, the Bible says, but seek ye first the kingdom and all his righteousness, and all these things are going to be added unto us. Hallelujah. You have to understand, whoever you are this morning, that you have an assignment. And God will call you into account for the assignment he has given to you when you die. Let me tell you something. If you are a fan of movies, whenever the part for the star is over, he's played his part, he dies, and that's the end of it. I don't know how long you have, or I have, but one of the things you want to be able to say is like the Apostle Paul, I have fought a good fight. When we hear about deaths, we get scared, but you hear me, all of us are going to die. All of us will end up in a coffin one of these days. But the coffin is not the problem. Not just where the body will rest. But when you're dead, you're not done. For the Bible says that beyond the grave, there is life. It is appointed unto man once to die, and after death comes the judgment. The question is this morning, am I fulfilling my assignment on the earth? Am I doing what God has called me to do? I'm not saying that you should not work and earn money and build houses. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that your number one priority is to ensure that the will of God for your life first is accomplished. The Bible tells us that after it is all said and done, only what is done for Christ is going to last. The first thing I want to share with you this morning is that your assignment is given by God. Your assignment is given by God. It is not the pastor. What I do when I ask you to get involved in a ministry, I am helping you. You don't understand that. So whenever I ask you to get involved in a ministry, what is really happening? I am helping you to fulfill your divine purpose on the face of the earth. It is never about using anybody. What we are doing when we ask you to get involved is for you to recognize that your focus has to shift into you fulfilling God's will for your life. So what the pastor does, he gives you the opportunity so that you could do what God has called you to do. Look at John 15, verses 16 to 19. What it says, you have not, but I have, and what? That you should go and. It is God who has called you out of all your brothers, all your sisters, all your cousins. It is God who has called you. And the Bible says he has ordained you that you will go forth and what? Bring much fruit. We sit in church and we think that coming to church is just good enough. That's it. Well, I went to church. Let me tell you something. It's God who gives assignments. Not the pastor. Whatever you do is not for me. Whatever you do is not for me. Whatever I give you the opportunity to do, it is to help you fulfill God's purpose for your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And you are given the opportunity to sing, then sing for his honor. Dance, dance for his honor. Whatever you are given the opportunity to do, remember, I'm not doing this for the pastor. I'm not doing this to please the church. I'm doing this understanding my assignment on the earth is to be a blessing in my particular skill or area of ministry. So I am just the forerunner. I just create the parts. It is your responsibility now to say, Lord, whatever you bless me with, whatever your assignment is for my life, I want to do it. We have a bunch of people in the church who are just getting fat. Warming the pews. Don't understand anything about assignments, and very soon you will reach the age of 70 or you'll reach the age of expiry. Listen to me, not because you're Christian mean that you would not die. Second thing this morning, not only your assignment is given by God, but our assignment attracts enemies. 2 Timothy 3 and 12, hear what the Bible says. All they that shall live godly in Christ shall what? Shall suffer persecution. You see there? All David did was kill Goliath. And the same king who hired him now wanted to kill him. Let me tell you this, some people just can't handle your success. And not everybody is happy for you. Psalms 34, 19, David says, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord will deliver us out of it all. Psalms 3 and verse 1, David says, oh Lord, how are they increased? But trouble me. John 15, 24, it says, they hated me and my father. As you begin to do your assignment, you will attract enemies. Everybody is not going to like you. You hear me, brothers and sisters? As you begin to function in the divine will of God, don't expect everybody to clap you. Everybody would not celebrate you. They won't agree with you. Sometimes the people are in your very house. Jesus says, as they hated me, they would also hate you. But he was about his Father's business, and he could care less. The problem is, we are so concerned about our image, and we are afraid to do what we are called to do because we don't want to offend nobody. You hear me, my friend? Like it or not, the gospel will offend. Hallelujah. Like it or not, hallelujah, not everybody would believe what you believe and will be offended because of what you believe. Then to God be the glory. If they hated Christ, they will also hate me. Hallelujah. You hear me this morning. Your assignment will attract enemies. Every one of you here this morning, hear me this morning. You are not going to get it easy as you stand for Christ. I don't want to fool you and make you feel if you come to Christ, everything will be all right. The hardest thing to do for some people is the right thing. It's easy to lie. Doing the wrong seems so easy. Everybody pats you on the back and says, okay, we all make mistakes. The moment you stand up for what is right, you have to be like that. Always so churchy. And to make you feel that what you're doing is wrong. And therefore you should compromise your integrity. I say to you this morning, hallelujah. Throughout the Bible, you see where Jesus stood, hallelujah. He understood his assignment was to go to the cross. And while he was going to the cross, there were enemies. And the enemies of Christ were more those who were, probably we call them church people. The scribe and the Pharisees. There are some scribes in your life. And some Pharisees who always feel that they could interpret the scripture for you and tell you what it means. Why are you going to church so often? And begin to play with your mind. And you don't have nothing to say to them. You begin to ponder, why are I going so often in truth? And you never ask them, why are you going to party so often? And why are you fetting so much? You can't ask them that, but they're asking you, why are you going to church so often? Since I'm small, I hear Christ coming. Since you're small, the grace of God was upon your life. Hallelujah. Since you're small, God's grace was upon your life. But there will come a day when your expiry dates will reach. And too late is going to be your cry. We allow them to frustrate us and pull us back into the world. Why? Because we don't have relationship with God. Jesus understood his assignment. And no matter what happened, he was not shivering from that at all. Until then, last this morning, my assignment would also attract favor. Your assignment not only attracts enemies, but it attracts the favor of God. Let me tell you something. Whatever God orders for, he pays. Say, neighbor, whatever God orders, he pays. You are talking to your neighbor. Say, neighbor, whatever God orders, he pays. He pays. Hallelujah. As you begin to fulfill your assignment in life, God is going to supply your every need. God will give you what is necessary. You don't always get up front. But sometimes it is in the journey that God provides for you. Many of us want to get it first. We want to see it first. But sometimes it's in the journey. Israel was going through the wilderness, and along the way, God provided. Manna came down. Water came out the rocks. Hallelujah. God provided a cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night. You hear me this morning? When you begin to do the assignment of God, it attracts the favor of God upon your life. Some of you, what you saved and worked for years could happen in one day with favor from Almighty God. Hallelujah. You see, we keep trying to make it happen for ourselves. But you need to understand, if I let go and I let God, he who sees in secret will reward me openly. All I need to do is be obedient and watch God work things out in Jesus' name. But you hear me this morning. The assignment of God brings favor upon your life. As you begin to walk in God's will and do what he has called you to do, rest assured, the things you have need of, the Bible says, God will add it to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Many times we walk around quoting scripture verse, but it is not applicable. You have to be very careful how you quote the Bible. There's a principle that God operates by. If you're living crazy, then you can say, God, protect me. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. You're going to starve. There is always a principle. God operates with principle. If you do that, then I will do this. If you are willing and obedient, God says, then you will eat the fat of the land. There has to be a willingness and obedience before you eat the fat of the land. Some of us feel that we could just live anyhow and do what we want and call down scripture. It ain't working. You're doing obia. You're practicing obia. And I rebuke that obia spirit in the name of Jesus. You can't live how you want to live and call long scriptures. Then walk in. Some of us don't even give. And we say, God will bless us. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together. Hello, that ain't happening. Somebody is blessing you. Give and it shall be given unto you. The principle is you give first. And I will give unto you. Time has come for us to stop the emotions and get serious with God. As I close this morning, your assignments attracts favor. Jesus was walking and he says, "Go, you go so and so, and you'll see a donkey tie so and so. Tell the owner, I have need of it. And you will get some favor." Man walked up and said, "My master had need of this." And they released the donkey. Favor. As you walk in your assignment.
Thank you for taking time off to listen. We hope that you were ministered to by the Holy Spirit. Join us for any of our Power Pack services. Sundays, 8 a.m. and 6 p.m. Wednesdays, 10 a.m. and 7 p.m. Friday, 7 p.m. God bless you. Shalom.